Hi, this is Pastor Morris coming to you on Gospel Talk. We discuss the gospel of Jesus Christ in a way that can be understood by anybody. Kindly invite your friends, like, share, comment, subscribe, and let us know what, you know, whether this is blessing you, and we'd like to get your feedback. God bless you so much. Today, I want to talk about something that, you know, I've encountered so many times when talking to people. It's about loving God or loving Jesus. When I talk to people and try to share the gospel of Jesus Christ with them and try to get a decision from them to believe in Jesus Christ, the excuse many people give is that, me, I love God. I love Christ. I love Jesus. And some of them even go further and says, who hates God? Who would hate Christ, you know? But today I want to talk to you about that. What is the love of God according to Christ? What is loving God? And I want to look at the book of John chapter 14 and verse 20. Let's begin there. It says, at that day you will know that I am in my Father, and you in me, and I in you. He who has my commandments and keeps them, it is he who loves me. He who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. So clearly, Jesus is saying, number one, that he who has my commandments, he who keeps my commandments. Elsewhere in the same book of John, he says, he who keeps my word, my message, he is the one that loves me, because you cannot love him and turn away from what he teaches or from his message or from his gospel. To love Christ is to love his message, is to love and keep his commandments. And he says something that's very, very telling in that particular verse, verse 21. He says that he who loves me, my Father will love him. That's what he says. He says that he who loves me will be loved by my Father. Therefore, you are seeing that in the New Testament, the love of God is loving Christ, and that God loves the ones that love his Son. Because if you love Christ, you are loving the one that sent him. You are loving his Father. It's very, very important. You cannot deny Christ and claim to love God, the Father. You cannot turn away from Jesus Christ and you claim that you love the Father. He says, he who loves me, my Father will love him. That God responds to us in love, you know, when we love Christ. When you accept Christ, God himself opens his heart of love to you. And whatever it is that is contained in his heart, he pours it upon you. Because you have loved his Son. To love his Son is to love him. That's very, very important. In the book of John, there were people that were arguing and debating with Christ about how they believe in Moses and how, you know, or they believe in Abraham. But there is a scripture here that Jesus shares with them. In the book of John chapter 5 verse 46, he tells them, for if you believed Moses, you would believe me, for he wrote about me. They were claiming to believe in the law of Moses. They were claiming to believe in the Old Testament. They were claiming to believe the teachings of Moses. And Jesus said, if you believed in Moses, then you should believe in me. Yeah, because Moses talked about me. That is the unity of the Bible. You can't claim to love one and hate the other. You can't claim to embrace God the Father and not embrace God the Holy Spirit. You cannot claim to embrace God the Father and turn your back on Jesus Christ. To love Christ is to love God the Father. I want to also read John 16, verse 26. I do not say to you that I shall pray the Father for you, for the Father himself loves you because you have loved me. To love Christ is to love the Father. And when you love Christ, the Father himself loves you. So that's very, very important. And I've learned in the Bible that you cannot turn away from one member of the Trinity and embrace the other and claim to fully love that member of the Trinity. If you love the Father, then you will love the Son. That's what he says. He says, if you believe in my Father, or you receive, he who receives me receives the one who sent me. To love God the Father is to love Christ. To love Christ is to love God the Father. And when you have received Christ, you can't turn away from the Holy Spirit, because he's the Spirit of Christ. God bless you so much for listening, and I pray that you have loved Christ. Because when you love Christ, you love God the Father. When you receive Christ, you receive the one who sent him. God bless you so much. Please like it, comment on it, share it, and subscribe. Let's spread the word of the love of God and the gospel of Jesus Christ. See you next time. God bless you.